just that we believe in each other. And, you know, in those sorts of games, you know, there's a really good team like that. Things are, you know, really not going to go your way at all times. And to bounce back and rely on each other and to make plays, and believe in all the work that we've done this year and, you know, what our program stands for, I think was a good thing.
Duncan.
Yeah, no, I can't wait.
Duncan, how hard was it to get looks out there from long range today?
It was tough. I mean, they're so long, defensively and active and athletic. So that was a challenge. You know, I thought we found ways to score in other areas of the floor, which was huge.
Bad start, actually bad finish to the first half. Talk about what the mood was in the locker room half.
There was a lot of belief, to be honest with you. There was a lot of conversation amongst the players, and, you know, we just believed that we banded together and stuck to what we kind of did in the first half, just effort-wise and energy-wise that we could find, and that we'd make plays, and that was the difference in the game.
Does this kind of feel like a team of destiny? I hate to say that. It's kind of corny.
I try to stay away from using the word destiny just because I feel like we all believe that we're more than good enough to be here. You know, it's not, you know, some exterior power that's kind of pushing us through, but instead what we kind of believed in all year.
Does it kind of bother you when people call you a Cinderella team, given how well you've played the second half of the year? You don't feel like a Cinderella team, right?
It doesn't necessarily bother us, but we just don't take it to our head. And, you know, we know that we're here for a reason, and it's not some fluke. Or, every March, you got some team that kind of squeaks our way through, but, you know, we feel like we're playing the best basketball of our season, and hopefully we can maintain it.
You feel like you can win this whole tournament? No, I guess you probably
absolutely
already feel
that. Absolutely, yeah. We felt that for a while now.
Have you been to Kansas City before?
I have, actually.
Looking forward to a return trip.
I'm very excited. I got a couple of friends out there. Some fun to see.
When Derek's got the ball with the clock winding down there, and you guys are up two, any doubt in your mind that he was going to score there?
No. You know, he's made a huge play for us all year.
Yeah.
You know, that situation was no different. Incredible play by him. And, you know, that was such a turning point in the game. Obviously, kind of put him in the back for us.
Talk about most play. Obviously, came up huge for you.
Yeah, when you got a guy playing like that, and just being able to attack like that, you know, it's huge. And, you know, he was so good attacking the rim and scoring inside, and to have that consistent scoring and efficient scoring is huge for us.
You guys went to the bigs more in the second half. Was there an emphasis at halftime to exploit the smaller guard on the bigger forward?
Yeah, I mean, they did a really good job of guarding the three-point line. I think they, you know, switched a lot of their screens. So, you know, there's a little strategy there to kind of mix it up on them, and I thought it was effective. So credit to our coach.
What was it about Mahmoud and Mafiang that was so good guarding that three-point line when you guys switched?
I mean, they're long and they're quick. You know, they move well for guys their size, and they have such great length. And, you know, it's not easy, but it's easier for them than a lot of other bigs to go
through. What was it like getting this win for B-line, considering him and his sister? What was it like getting this win for B-line, considering him and
his sister? We're thrilled. You know, I know he wanted this one really, really badly. And, you know, for him, for us to win it for him and us and this program and the university and all the Michigan fans out there is incredible.
You can't have a sort of effort like this.